How you guys doing? Welcome to Indoor Hydroponics. I'm John, your indoor hydroponic test dummy. Today is January 7th or 8th, something like that, 2016. It's a Saturday morning, so I have not had a chance to bring in my makeup and hair people, so forgive me. Regardless, I've been kept up all night by the thought of weak seedlings, okay? And by that I mean I want to talk about cucumbers. Cucumbers that I started some 3 weeks ago. Now, these seedlings are ready, but they're not looking all that great, man. I mean, they're stunted, got a great root system right here, but the thing about cucumbers is that they're very sensitive when it comes to their roots, okay? That's what makes transplanting them outdoors, that type of thing, kind of touchy, all right? And plus, they need a lot of humidity, which we're not getting in here, so I put it in this little dome here. I release the dome every once in a while just to kind of give them a little fresh air, and then I pop it back in, right? So today I want to get these into some nutrient, man, because they are way, way, way past due, and I think we can save them. I don't know how I want to plant them quite yet. I know I want to do something easy. I know I want to do all four plants, and I know I want to string them up to the ceiling somehow. And I want to kind of do a wavy type thing, but first we got to figure out a grow method. Something easy, probably cracky, maybe some aeration. And I got some perlite from the hardware store on sale for $5 for a big bag of it. But I don't think we're going to need a lot of it. Maybe we're going to try to grow these in styrofoam cups and set them into some solution somehow. Let's get to work.
Wondering. I'm thinking a 10-gallon tote. 1¼-inch net cups for cucumbers. That sounds like not enough room, but I think we can do it. Let's give it a try. Okay, what we got going on here is a 10-gallon tote, okay? Or rubber, whatever, tote, you know, the totes! Anyways, it's 10 gallons. Got it lifted up just a little bit here, okay? I want to get it a little bit closer to the light so it's sitting on another tote. Got about 36-inch gap between the top of the tub and the light. It's got a 400-watt metal halide bulb in underneath or over top of it. We're obviously oxygenating a little bit with a couple of air stones set to low. I actually am going to use this to mix up the nutrient. Now, obviously there's only about 8 gallons in here because when we put the top on, the net cups are going to sink down. So when we're doing adding nutrient and amendments to this water, we want to not add it up to the 10 gallons. We actually want to account for the loss for the depth of the net cup. So the very first thing when we're doing any kind of nutrient is you want to put in Kelmag first if you're growing fruiting vegetables. So what I'm going to use is a General Hydroponics Kelmag here, and it says 1 teaspoon per gallon, so I'm going to need about 8 teaspoons, which seems a little high to me, actually. So I'm probably, let's see. Excuse you. I'm probably going to do a half dose of that, okay, and just kind of let it mix up like that. And I'm going to let this go for a little bit. And then the next step after this is all good and mixed up is to add our actual nutrient, okay? And remember, the Kelmag is to prevent that blossom end rot on the bottom of fruiting vegetables. So it's very important that that gets in there.
But what are we making?
Well, we're making a nutrient solution, which is plant food for our cucumber seedlings. Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
So we have to add just the right amount of plant food, Kylie, to get this right. And Okay. This is the stuff that makes, this is the stuff we want to add first, okay? So let's let this mix up for a little while, and then we'll come back in and we'll add our nutrient, which is our plant food, okay?
Okay.
Fist. Boom! Kay. Fist. Boom! All right, guys, so we're good and mixed up so far here. We've got that 8 gallons going now. You probably might be asking yourself, well, why did I go half solution on the Kelmag? Well, that's because we're dealing with seedlings here. We're not dealing with full-grown plants, so we want to go light on our hydroponic nutrients. So
What I'm going to do here is now put in some of this Fox Farm Grow Big. This is the grow formula. We'll eventually switch it over to bloom once the vines start to grow out. It's about a half a teaspoon per gallon for seedlings, okay? So altogether, about 4 teaspoons of hydroponic nutrient is going to be added to this. Now, what we're going to do is let this completely mix up. And as well, yeah, I have some of these net cups here just kind of rinsing off in the solution. So let's let that mix up for a while. Okay, so growing in a 10-gallon tub with 4 cucumber plants is going to take up quite a bit of maintenance. And what I mean by that is we're going to have to do some top-offs every week and probably do an adjustment on the nutrients every week. Now, last year I grew in a 26-30-gallon tote. And it actually got me way, 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 way far into the grow before I even had to think about refilling. But this is going to be different, okay? So we're going to do a smaller container, more plants, and we're really going to maximize our grow with 4 cucumbers, okay, guys? All right, guys, we don't necessarily need all fancy hydroponic equipment type of thing to have a successful grow. However, these total dissolved solid pens, these are your parts per million pens. These tell us how concentrated our nutrient is within the solution. And it gives us a ballpark range, okay? How accurate are these things? I don't know. But it gets us in the ballpark. And so with the CalMag and hydroponic nutrient solution all mixed up within here, using tap water, I might add, just right out of the faucet, we're at about 633 parts per million, which seems pretty weak at this point, okay, because adult cucumber vines can run up between 1,000, 1,500, sometimes even higher, though I don't want to burn them out. But remember, we're dealing with seedlings here, and as these things grow and reduce, and the water levels start to go down, if I choose to let it go down, it's going to be much more concentrated because the plants are going to take up water faster than they are nutrient. And so, as the water levels go down, our parts per million is going to go up, and sometimes at a significant rate. So keep that in mind. Maybe we want to check that as this goes, especially using a smaller container. Okay, fellas. The biggest thing with hydroponics is obviously you want light, you want nutrient, and you want to make sure your pH is stable. Why do you want to make sure your pH is in the right zone? Because plants uptake nutrients within a certain pH zone. 5.5 to about 7.0 is about where you want to be. I like to be in about the 6 to 6.5 range, okay? Now, they make these pH pens, okay, but you know what? Mine broke. So I'm going with your atypical little thing for the fish tank type of thing, little sticks, you put them in there. Hey ma'am, we just want to be in the ballpark. We don't need to have this perfect and dialed in. We're going to add a little bit of pH down to it. Right now, coming out of the tap, my water runs pretty high on the pH. It's up right around 8.0. So I just did a test on this, and it is still pretty high up on the scale. Another cool thing that these little things check on is for chlorine. Now chlorine, you want to make sure that your water is dechlorinated, and by running this here, it'll take all the chlorine out of it, so that's pretty cool too. Now, where are we at? We're still at about an 8.0, even with all the nutrients added. Now we want to adjust that after our nutrients have been inputted, okay, because we don't want to jack this up after we put the nutrients in. So let's add a little bit of this, come back, remeasure, we should be good to go. All right, now with most hydroponic nutrient stuff, I don't really mind if the kids are around type of thing. We're going to wash our hands up. It's going to be all right, okay? But when we're dealing with pH down, we're talking about acid, adding it in here, okay? It's an acidic solution, bringing the pH down. Don't really like the idea of the kids touching that at full concentration, so use your brains, guys. Anyway, it's been mixing up a little bit. We're going to do one of these. We're going to see if we're in the ballpark, and if we are, ooh, look at that. Lightened right up. Perfect. Mm-hmm. We're low sixes. See, it's on the low scale right there. No chlorine, low sixes. I'm happy. We can start planting. All right, now, what we want to do is make sure that these net cups, when we stick them in here, are just barely touching the water, which they are. Thank you, Kylie. So we actually hit this just perfect on the first try. If they're not hitting the bottom of the net cups, obviously just add a little bit more water, guys, until it hits the bottom of the net cups. We want the roots to suspend down into the nutrient solution, obviously. So We got our cups in. And we've got our struggling cucumbers here with some good root action going on, but you can see they're kind of folded over. They're not very happy. They haven't been fed yet, and they're about 3 weeks old, so that's not good, guys. So what we're going to do is try to save these little dudes, right? And we're just going to kind of push them in here for now. And believe me when I say this, the roots will eventually expand out into the solution and grow down into it, okay? Ooh, that has a massively good root. Look at that one. Kind of, yeah. Let me get the camera up on that. There we go. Look at that one. That's good root system. Okay, what we actually might want to do on that particular one is feed that through a little bit. Might want to see if we can feed that long root through. Get it on down there. There's another good one. Man, this has a really unbelievable root system already. So,
yeah.
I believe that's what they call a taproot. But I might be wrong on that. Let's finish. All right, guys, some old, crusty, three-week-old Asian dragon cucumber seedlings have been planted. We got a ways to go here, but they are sitting now suspended in the nutrient. I probably will feed at least one air stone into this, and I'll let it run. I probably will even go with two. Now, we do have a couple of extra holes there, and I'm thinking what we could do is probably grow a quick lettuce in there while these are growing out. What do you think? Yeah, I think it's a good idea too. As fate would have it, I have two perfect lettuce seedlings at the perfect point. All right, guys, here's the final product. We've got our cucumbers, lettuce going on in there. Got the aeration kicking on in there through the hose. Gonna be sitting under a 400-watt metal halide bulb, 18 hours a day through the grow period, okay? So hopefully these babies will perk right on up, these old, crusty old seedlings type of thing. We'll come back, we're gonna do a maintenance video on it as they grow out. In addition, we're gonna do some fun things on how to string these babies up type of thing in a grow room inside. So hopefully this was enough information to get us started with some fruiting vegetables. As always, thanks for watching. Peace out, Indoor Hydroponics.